you. You'll be glad you chose Dove Chevrolet Buick Cadillac on West 10th, right next to Brahms in Great Bend. Good luck, Eagles. Calling all businesses, large or small. See the experts at National Billing for your account receivable billing, financing, and management needs. Let National Billing do your customer billing, freeing your valuable time and energy to manage or grow your business. National Billing provides immediate financing of your receivables, providing the cash to pay bills or invest in your business. National Billing is the expert in billing, collecting, and management. Contact Mel Waite and the staff for a non-obligation consultation. Located at 13 North Main, Ellenwood, a proud Ellenwood Eagles supporter.
Welcome back. We're set for Ellenwood Eagle basketball. Ellenwood Eagles and Wichita Northfield Suns getting ready to take center stage. The nightcap, the late game. We close out game one of the tournament. We're still waiting for the Suns to reappear here in the gym. Jared, let's go ahead and take another quick break. They're getting ready for the national anthem, so we're going to take a break, come back with you in about 2 or 3 minutes for the starters, and then the tip. It's the Wichita Northfield Suns and the Ellenwood Eagles, the nightcap of the Ellenwood preseason basketball tournament.
Hi, I want to tell you about a neat jewelry store, Family Jewels and Silver, just south of the courthouse in Great Bend. They have a huge selection of loose gemstones. They do awesome custom designs in both gold and silver. And they have expert gold and silver repairs. They carry watch batteries and bands, as well as a lovely selection of earrings, pendants, and bracelets. Stop in today and receive 25% off any purchase through Christmas. Family Jewels and Silver, just south of the courthouse in beautiful downtown Great Bend.
Dole Insurance Group of Ellenwood would like to wish all the Ellenwood athletes good luck all season. For all your insurance needs, stop by Dole Insurance Group, located on East Santa Fe, and visit with Richard. Dole Insurance Group, proud to support Ellenwood Eagles sports. The Ellenwood Booster Club would like to wish all the Eagle athletic teams good luck this season. Support the Eagles and join the Ellenwood Booster Club by contacting a booster committee member. The Ellenwood Booster Club, a proud supporter of Eagle sports. Ellenwood Packing Plant is proud to be a sponsor of Ellenwood Eagles Sports. Serving Central Kansas for over 30 years, Ellenwood Packing Plant is your main source for beef and pork cuts. Plus, don't forget about the fresh deli. Ellenwood Packing Plant wishes all the Ellenwood Eagle athletes good luck and congratulates them on achieving the teamwork, leadership, and good sportsmanship. Ellenwood Packing Plant on 56 Highway, just west of Ellenwood.
Serves is your convenient stop to kick off or end any Eagle football game. So, huddle on into Serves. Serves is everything you need to tackle your thirst. Warm up or cool down with a wide selection of convenient food and flavorful drinks, including the Snowball. Serves has it all. And don't forget to fuel up with Conoco Gas at Serves. Don't sit on the sidelines. See what's in store at Serves. Fill up.
Starting lineups are being introduced. The Wichita Northfield, the Suns, and your Eagles from Ellenwood. Nice victory for the Ellenwood Lady Eagles. They get their win, 47-32. Kyle Corbett gets the start, along with Kyle Blakesley, Kale Clausen, Patrick Ringering, and Ian Gehring. Starting for the Ellenwood Eagles, coached by Shane Duncan. Ellenwood lost game one of the season to Russell back on Friday night. And we're getting the starters real quick for Northfield. Adam Yoder, a 5'11 sophomore. Also, Quentin Zimmerman, a 5'10 sophomore. Adrian Maloney, a 5'6 junior, their best all-around player. Here's a young man we saw dunk it earlier tonight, 6'5 junior, Garrett Allen. And finally, Damian Beasy, a 5'7 junior. It's a very talented, very athletic team for Wichita in their purple and white West. This is going to be fun.
Absolutely. The kid everybody remembers is Maloney from 2 years ago. He came in as a youngster, maybe around 5 foot, not very big, but he could beat just about anybody off the dribble. And now he's come back as a junior. He's up to 5'6", and Coach Duncan definitely says they have to contain him. He doesn't even think they can completely stop him. And, of course, Beasy, we saw him dunk for. He's got size and extreme athleticism. So here we go, Steve.
39-28 was the final against Russell. Ellenwood does not win the tip.
May not see it much this year, but Ellenwood's starting out in a man-to-man tonight.
Inside play, no good on the rebound. Let's see, the whistle was on. Was it on Ellenwood? Yes.
They're going to whistle Cale Clausen. I couldn't really see it on the backside of the play there. Yoder goes to the line here to start the game. To play Ellenwood could run the exact same thing down here on the offensive end as what we saw there, looking for a backdoor cut opportunity to score at the rim. Ellenwood just doesn't have that size, but that's what they're probably going to run down here if Duncan sticks with what he told me.
Both free throws are good.
Unforced turnover for the Eagles, Steve.
That's not a good sign at all to start this game for the Ellenwood Eagles. 2-0, just underway. Northfield has the ball in the lead, man-to-man by Ellenwood. Northfield really spreading out the offense in the turnover by their big guy. As he caught the ball up top, 6'5 junior Garrett out.
Ellenwood's going to switch it up a lot defensively, but tonight we're going to talk about a man-to-man, and I don't know how many more times this season Ellenwood's going to go with a man-to-man.
We'll see how long they stick to that man-to-man tonight.
Should be a switch off of makes and misses. We'll see how that goes.
Inside. Back out to Clausen. Clausen up top to Corbett. There's a three. No good. That was the difference in the game Friday night. A bunch of threes.
Boy, Coach Duncan certainly has ultimate confidence in his players. He felt like, even with all the misses, his shooters are Kyle Corbett and Kyle Blakely, and he's confident that they're going to knock those shots down.
Yeah, they didn't shoot too well the other night, but they'll come out firing tonight. See if they can get it going early.
Here's Maloney with the ball in his hand, gives it up, and we've got a travel.
Traveling.
Two turnovers apiece early.
Traveling with the basketball back to back. Just Northfield trying to set their feet. By the time they do, they've already traveled with the ball.
Kyle Corbett to bring it up. Looks like a 1-3-1, Steve. Could be carving copies on either end here.
Northfield really getting after the basketball. They pick up Blakesley on the inside. He's blocked. Gets his own rebound. It's blocked again. Ball still fought for. Blakesley and the big man inside. 6'5", Garrett Allen. There is nobody in this tournament that's as big and lengthy as Linkley as he is. Timeout, 30. Keep it here.
Two early blocks by Allen. He could come up with big numbers.
Timeout on the court. We would like to take this opportunity to thank tonight's sponsors, Next Tech Wireless and Star 107.9. Timeout on the court. We would like to take this opportunity to thank tonight's sponsors, Next Tech Wireless and Star 107.9.
For Wichita Northfield came up and talked to me before the game, making sure we had everybody. They're going to add number three, David McAdams. He's a senior from the information we got. Don't know much else about him.
2-0. Northfield with the basketball. Here's a 1-3-1 out of Ellenwood out of the timeout.
And there you can see the early change. Patrick Ringering, instead of being out around the top of the key, is meeting the ball out about half court so they can set that trap out higher. Turnover Northfield.
It's Maloney, the 5'6 point guard. A good ball handler, but he couldn't handle that basketball. There's a lob inside, goes through the hands of Ellenwood. Turnover, their second.
A good effort by Patrick Ringering trying to run that thing down. It almost went through the brick wall there,
but
still a turnover Eagles. Ellenwood's coming out with that extended 1-3-1. Patrick Ringering way out at half court. Ian Gehring knocks that ball out of bounds. Northfield will get it underneath. 6:04 to play. Northfield leading it 2-0.
Northfield has no fouls as a team. There's Maloney with it. Thought about the three from 18, but he passes it off to Vizi. First sub of the game. This is David McAdams, the senior.
Boy, Northfield, one of the unknown quantities. And just Coach Duncan talked to his brother, who does some coaching down in the Wichita area, and got a little bit of information on him. A miss there on a three by Quentin Zimmerman. Ellenwood up with the ball. Kyle Corbett into the front court.
Corbett between the circles, looking inside. He finds Clausen. Clausen back to Corbett, to Gearing, to Ringering. Corbett too high. Turnover to number three.
Good ball movement by the Eagles there. Just kind of a shaky pass at the end of the sequence there. Here comes Cody Ezrin into the ball game, maybe to settle things down. Patrick's done for a little bit. Flaps his hands in frustration. He's going to have to relax himself.
Patience is what Northfield has, and that's what they're doing right now. There's a 12-footer that's way short, but it's fouled. Going to the free throw line to shoot two is Garrett Allen.
Foul's going to be on Ian Gearing inside. Picks up his first. Coach Duncan kind of presented Ian with the challenge before this game. He really wants Ian to be a post presence in this game tonight. Let's see how often and hard Ian posts up.
First free throw, banks in.
Not a thing of beauty going off the backboard, but it still counts as a point.
Sure does for Garrett Allen.
Eagles now down 3-0.
Garrett Allen dips, shoots, uses the glass, doesn't go.
Ian Gearing rips down that rebound. Here comes Kyle up to half court.
And set up the offense. Show of man-to-man. Nope, 1-3-1 applied by Northfield. Clausen has the basketball. He gets it over to Cody Ezrin. Cody Ezrin inside to Gearing. Gearing back to Clausen from 13 on that left side. No good. Offensive rebound, Corbett.
Kyle Corbett got in amongst the trees there with an offensive rebound.
Ball will go out of bounds to Ellenwood. The foul was on the floor. That was Garrett Allen, the big guy.
Turnover, Eagles.
Is that their fourth already?
I've got them for five, but
yep,
if you want to call it four.
That does look like five. Northfield on the other end, they turn it over. Stepping out of bounds is Garrett Allen.
So far, a raggedy basketball game. Coach Duncan felt like one area where Ellenwood could possibly have an advantage, basketball IQ and basketball experience. Maybe they don't, the Eagles don't have the size, but they've played a little more basketball and maybe might be better basketball players.
You know, right now, they're getting outplayed by Northfield. Corbett inside to Christensen, who just checked in. Now he turned it over.
Jake airmailed that ball out of bounds. I am very surprised to see this rash of turnovers for the Eagles. That's six already. Northfield with a ball and a three-point advantage. 4.5 left in the first.
Not even 1 point on the board set for Ellenwood. Just six turnovers. David McAdams just flat lost it. Turnover again. This one on Northfield.
Dueling turnovers.
And Blakely is unable to get anything going. Christensen can't get a right into the layup. Rebound comes to McAdams, the senior. And he gets trapped there on the sideline. Now the ball is loose. Who gets it? Christensen. He gets it to Corbett.
There's a lot of different ways Coach Duncan traps out of the 1-3-1. That was on first bounce over half court.
Blakely, he wants a shot. He dribbles baseline. He throws up a right-handed shot. Won't go. Christensen gets the offensive rebound. He cannot get it to fall. The ball is tipped out and rebounded by Corbett. His dribble drive, right-handed layup is good.
Kyle with a great offensive rebound. Put the ball on the floor twice. Slashed between two defenders. Got the ball up off the glass and in. First points of the evening for the Eagles.
That could be the momentum change that they needed. It goes off of the purple. Nick Adams.
Turnovers were even at six when Ellenwood got their first bucket. Let's see if Ellenwood now can cut those turnovers and make a little run.
Patrick Ringering back on the floor for the Ellenwood Eagles. Corbett has it. 1-3-1. No, 1-2-2 look kind of by Northfield. Ringering calls for the ball. He finds Clausen, 12-footer. Way too short, but Christensen's there. But a foul. Ellenwood gets to keep the ball because Quentin Zimmerman used his lower body backing in on Christensen.
Jake really active down low. He's got three shots. He's not a scorer. We've seen that in the 0-for-3 but he does have two offensive rebounds, so Jake's in there working hard.
Clawson comes out, Gearing back on the floor. Ring to check it in to Corbett for three from the right side. No, it was in and out. Here comes Damon Vizek running with the basketball. There's a shot, will not go, but fouled is Adrian Maloney, the junior.
Adrian Maloney's quick as a hiccup. Ellenwood definitely has to get back and stop the dribbler. He could have a big night. He's not the biggest guy, but he's a scorer. He's a basketball player, somebody that really impressed Coach Duncan.
First free throw right in there. All the points so far for Wichita are from the free throw line. There's one that also is good. 5 points on the board to two. Ellenwood trails by three. 3:07 left. Wakely out, has yet to score. I don't even think he has shot a couple times. Christensen inbound to Corbett.
Kyle had a good look into Jake at one point. Jake wasn't able to finish.
1-3-1. Defense by Wichita. Ringering. Bounce pass. High post Christensen to Corbett. Corbett trying to find somebody. He dribbles inside. He gets hammered around. No call. Ball is saved. Ringering will run it down.
Allen with yet another block on the Corbett drive.
Beautiful ball movement. Ringering to Clawson. Inside to Gearing. Gearing able to get his first two of the game. Ellenwood's back in at 5-4.
Great look inside, like you said, from Kale to Ian. Maybe that'll get Ian's game going. He's got a look on his face like he's ready to play now.
Ellenwood tries to trap. They do. They get the trap, but dribbling out of it was Maloney, but he carried the basketball.
Well, and that's something you're going to see a different interpretation of that, carrying the basketball at almost every game you go to.
Yeah, everybody carries the basketball anymore. Gearing gets a sharp pass inside. Ringering thought about a three. He stepped just inside the arc for two. Patrick Ringering from downtown.
Boy, they're going cross-court and hitting Ian, and then he's just finding the open man. Great job of attacking that 1-3-1. Here's a trap.
6-5. Ellenwood is taking their first lead. Three-point shot from the corner. Good.
Boy,
that's Damian Vizek, the first field goal of the game for Wichita.
Damian Vizek covered up in the corner, not even sure how he saw the rim, but he drilled it.
Corbett, Clawson looking for Christensen. They swing it over, skip it over, actually, to Corbett. Back to Ringering. Ringering to Clawson. His shot won't go in. It did go in, but it popped right out. Quentin Zimmerman dribbling up the floor very quickly, stepping out of bounds, trying to get the steal to the senior Corbett.
Good hustle right by here with Kyle. Defense hasn't ever been the strong suit of Kyle's game, but he's certainly got a better defensive game coming into this year than I've seen in his 3 years as a starter. He's definitely put a lot of effort into improving his defense.
Cody comes back onto the floor. Ezern does. So it's Ringering, Corbett, Ezern, Christensen, and Gearing. 1:25 left in the first quarter, 8-6. Fast-moving quarter, last game of the first round of the Round Robin Tournament, the Ellenwood Preseason Basketball Tournament. There's a steal by Kyle Corbett. Right-handed layup. Up good. Ties the game up at 8.
Ellenwood went man-to-man there. Kyle just stepped out. Kind of surprised Northfield got a nice steal. Little lead out on the break. Finishes it off nicely. Ellenwood ties it at 8.
And there's a whistle on the other end on the inside. I believe it's personal foul. No, turnover. Stepped out of bounds. Was Wichita. That's their fourth, maybe fifth turnover at least already.
I hate to say it,
no,
but I've got them at 9.
Yeah, that's fine. I mean, I actually lost a few of their turnovers early on. I actually had the wrong sheet in front of me. I had to switch it.
Another block for Allen. He's got 4 already. Just got to keep attacking that big guy in there.
Yeah, he's 6'5". It's going to be very hard to get anything around him. Yoder picks up his first foul, team foul number 3. For Wichita. Kyle Corbett for 3, will not go, but a whistle. Gearing fighting for position, gets called for the foul.
That's 2 on Ian, I believe. And you know, there, I know Kyle's a shooter, but Kyle had all kinds of open space in front of him. Maybe 2 dribbles and he has a lot easier shot that he can maybe knock down, but he wanted the 3 and it just wouldn't fall for him.
Well, he likes to shoot that 3 ball where he was 2 of 14 in game number 1. Under a minute left, 8-8, we're in the first.
We've seen Maloney off the dribble once or twice.
Maloney wants to take it all the way to the hole, but he gets stripped away from Corbett, didn't get in the rebound, and traveling with Garrett. Garrett Allen, the 6'5 junior.
Well, I'm kind of with Garrett. I haven't seen the last two or three of these Northfield turnovers that the referees have whistled, but it doesn't hurt the Eagles any.
Not at all. 25 seconds to play. Cody Yezrin with it. We're in the first. Patrick Ringer inside. Nice turnaround move by Big Daddy Garrett Hayes. His first two of the game.
Great steal by Big Daddy Garrett Hayes, you like to call him. First points of the varsity season for Mr. Hayes.
What a quick dribble drive inside. Maloney. And then Ellenwood turns it over on the inbound.
That's a blow by. There you're seeing what Maloney can do. There is nobody maybe in this tournament with that kind of quickness. He can definitely get to the rack in a hurry.
Timeout on the court. We would like to take this opportunity to thank tonight's sponsors, Next Tech Wireless and Star 107.9.
And here's what they're going to do.
Timeout on the court. We would like to take this opportunity to thank tonight's sponsors, Next Tech Wireless and Star 107.9.
I don't know where the big guy's at right here, because when he comes out of the floor with 5.3 seconds left, that's where they're going. There's no questions to be asked about it. Garrett Allen, 6'5", he will slam it home. He's standing right in front of the guy throwing the ball in. Kyle Corbett's right in front of him. So let's see. He's going to come up top. It's an X. And then he's at the top of the key. They throw it into him, and he gets fouled. Patrick Ringer, that was easy. I mean, you just followed him. They're going to run the same thing. Coach Fair calls his team foul number 6. 5 seconds remaining before halftime. We're tied at 10. And we're just watching Garrett Allen here, Wes. He runs a little X, spins back up top. Maloney for 3 from the top of the circle. Will not fall. Kyle Corbett got the rebound. He lost the handle, picked it up at half court, throws it up, and it will not go. We started at 0, we're at 10. After 1, back after this on the Star 107.9.
Calling all businesses, large or small. See the experts at National Billing for your account receivable billing, financing, and management needs. Let National Billing do your customer billing, freeing your valuable time and energy to manage or grow your business. National Billing provides immediate financing of your receivables, providing the cash to pay bills or invest in your business.
And silver, just south of the courthouse in Great Bend. They have a huge selection of loose gemstones. They do awesome custom designs in both gold and silver. And they have expert gold and silver repairs. They carry watch batteries and...
Welcome back, Steve Owens, Wes Balin, the Star 107.9, game 4, the first day of the Ellenwood preseason basketball tournament.
Coach Duncan spent the last day or so trying to convince his Eagles that this isn't the same Northfield team that came in here 2 years ago and lost by 50.
No, they're not going to lose by 50.
They
not to anybody
in
this tournament.
Quarter.
There's nobody in this tournament that's going to defeat this Northfield team by 50. There's a foul called on maybe their big guy. If it is on Allen, that'll be number 2. We'll wait and see the official call. Corbett at the free throw line shooting 2. He hits the first one. He has 5 in the game. Big guy does come out, so he has 2 personal fouls. That's Garrett Allen.
That could definitely change things a little bit.
Coach Bear's trying to give him some instructions, and the second free throw is good. He's trying to show him. You got to be straight up. Maloney with the basketball. Off to Vizi. Vizi throws it up and it goes out of bounds off of Adam Yoder.
Ellenwood and Northfield stood at 6 on turnovers a while back. Ellenwood just has 7 now while Northfield has 11.
2-point shot, good.
Jake Christensen gets that first score of the year. Nice drive there by Cody Eason down the lane to set that up good to get Jake in the scorebook tonight.
Lots of players getting the touches on the basketball for Ellenwood. Ellenwood travel. A nice job of defense by Cody Ezern and Big Daddy Hayes, because it forced the left-handed ball handler for Wichita, made him undecisive. Did he want to dribble into the basket area or pass it off? When he made that decision, he drug his foot. Cody Ezern, three-point shot, ringering for three. Oh, no. Patrick Ringering banks it home. The bank remains open late in Ellenwood. Patrick Ringering, his first three of the night. 17-10. We were tied at 10 when we started the quarter. Turnover. Garrett gets it to Corbett. Corbett looks around. That's Cody Ezern. He gets it to him. Back to Corbett. Corbett thought about a three. Traveled it. This time he saw the opening. Put the ball on the floor. Was going to go to the left side. He traveled.
Still good to see out of Kyle when he puts the ball on the floor and attacks the rim. The three-point shot is not a place to live. You've got to get to the rim as well. That'll create more space for you if you like that three-pointer. You can put the ball on the floor and challenge him with the dribble.
Garrett Allen checks back into the lineup for Northfield. 6:35 to play in this first half of play. I was watching the action between Maloney and Allen. Maloney, the quickness and the speed, dribbled inside the paint and dished it off to Allen real quick, but Allen could not handle the quick, sharp pass. Now a sharp pass by Cody Ezern, and nobody can handle it but the wall.
Same thing down here on the other end. I think it was Jake. I couldn't really see down in the corner, but the ball just zipped right between his hands. Northfield has it again.
And Jake's a big defensive lineman or a center. He's not a wide receiver, and Cody forgot that. 17-10, 6:10 to play, first half. Hold by Garrett Hayes. He was holding Garrett Allen. Now look at that matchup. Garrett Hayes, 5'10", Garrett Allen, 6'5".
Garrett's going to battle. He's going to need to bring a lunch pail tonight if he's going to hang in with that.
Well, it's a seventh team foul, so going to the free throw line is Garrett Allen, where he's 1-for-2 tonight. And Coach Fair saying use the glass. That's what he did in the first two free throws. Oh, he didn't need no glass there. That was nothing but net right over the front of the iron.
Got a lot of raw talent and potential with this Northfield club.
Allen is a player. 6'5". He'll probably grow some more by next year. Work on his skill and his game and have a good attitude. He'll be great. And that's what we've seen so far tonight out of him. 17-12. Just a five-point lead now. First 2 points of the quarter for Wichita. Nice pass to Garrett Hayes from Kyle Corbett. Hayes over the outstretched arms of Garrett Allen. 19-12, 5:50, we're in the second.
Cody with a great dish. Kyle with a great dish inside to Garrett Hayes there.
High post to a low post, but it's turnovers.
Boy, if they wouldn't have the 15 turnovers, Northfield would really be a problem for the Eagles.
Boy, the officials are letting a few things go right now because Garrett Allen could have picked up his third foul easy. They will call.
The foul will go on Jake.
Christensen, his first. Team foul, 8, so 1-1. For David McAdams. Clawson and Blakesley, who got a long rest, back on the floor right now for Ellenwood. 1-1, first one good for McAdams. That's his first point. Here comes the second. The bonus, good. 4 points in the quarter for the team. They still trail, though, by five. Ellenwood with the ball up. 19-14, 5.5 left before the Barton Community College halftime show. Ringering, bounce pass, Blakesley. Turnaround shot, no good. Third foul coming up on the big guy, Garrett Allen. He's running, probably going to, well, he probably better just go to the bench or he's going to get number four.
Well, they went with number four.
Really?
That's what the referee said.
Yeah, Coach Fair even just turned around and said, hey, thanks, we needed that. And he told the official, thanks, we needed that one. Free throw misses by Blakesley. So Garrett Allen did not pick up his third. Yoder gets his first.
Kyle's gotten off to a rough start at the free throw line this year by his high standards.
Second throw, rattled in. 20-14, 5:20, we're in the second. Northfield goes very quickly down the floor with Maloney, handling the shot. He'll take it from 16 on the right side, won't go. Corbett got the board. He's up the floor quickly, looking down the floor, trying to decide what to do. He keeps it. Blakeslee for three in the right corner. He got it. Kyle Blakeslee finally breaks the ice. Kyle Blakeslee needed something to fall, and he finally got one to go from there. But on the other end, David McAdams for two, and he got it.
Well, one thing I think Kyle's doing different tonight is letting the game come to him.
Two-point shot by Blakeslee, I believe, misses, and fighting for the rebound was Clawson and Allen. Allen to shoot two, Clawson for the foul. Team foul number nine, still a 1-1.
We've got a 7-point game, but where would we be if Northfield didn't have the 15 turnovers?
Yeah.
It would be a dogfight if Northfield could clean up some of the turnovers that they've had.
They've shot 11 free throws, and they've only missed one.
I think early on, the multiple defenses that Coach Duncan was throwing at them were kind of a headache to them. But I think the athleticism has allowed him to earn all these free throws.
Second free throw misses, pulled down by Garrett Hayes. Off to Patrick Ringering. Ringering on the right side, lost the handle, turnover.
Oh, this is already going to be a high for Garrett Hayes as far as varsity minutes go, but I think he's played really well.
Ethan will come back onto the floor for Ringering.
One thing that's worked well against this zone, Kyle Blakeslee working the high post, getting the ball to some other people to get looks.
Maloney called for the carry again. And he is. I mean, he's putting his hand on the side of the basketball. Inbound to Blakeslee, 4:20 to play in the first half. 23-17, Ellenwood with the ball and the 6-point advantage. Go to Easer. Back over to Kyle Corbett. He's on the left baseline. Dribbles in. Right-handed layup. No good, but there's a foul. That is number three on Garrett out. No questions asked. Two shots coming up for Kyle Corbett, where he's 2-for-2 tonight.
It's a clinical job by Kyle Corbett there as a senior. A guy who likes to shoot the three, but he saw an opportunity. Ball fake, got baseline, and picked up that all-important third foul.
Corbett's free throw. Good. 3-for-3 now. 7 points.
That might be Kyle's best move of the young season already.
Okay, we got a timeout.
Timeout on the court. We would like to take this opportunity to thank tonight's sponsors, Next Tech Wireless and Star 107.9.
Free throw. Maybe an opportunity here for Coach Duncan to set up.
Timeout on the court. We would like to take this opportunity to thank tonight's sponsors, Next Tech Wireless and Star 107.9.
Where you can hear each and every game of the Ellenwood preseason basketball tournament. Sterling 49, Chase 6. That was a girls' game. 57-23, Sterling boys defeated Chase. Ellenwood girls defeated Wichita Northfield ladies 47-32, and in our contest here, it's 24-17. Ellenwood leads, and they're at the free throw line out of the timeout. Corbett misses it. It's too short. Ian Gehring with the offensive rebound. Back to Kyle Corbett. He dribbles in and gets it in. Kyle Corbett with another two. Has nine in the contest. Maloney lost his dribble, recovers. Now he throws it up from 12. Cannot find anything but Ian Gehring. Corbett getting the ball up the court quickly. Setting up his offense, still a 1-3-1. That's what we've seen the entire game. Blakeslee loses the handle, jump ball, goes over to Northfield. McAdams was on the floor battling.
Kyle Corbett's almost got as many points tonight as he had in the whole game, and that just comes from playing a more well-rounded game of basketball. Not just shooting the three or hanging out there, but also putting the ball on the floor, driving it, and dishing to his teammates.
3:40 left, 24-17. The extended defense now being shown by Ellenwood, and it works because Gehring's there to knock it away on the entry pass to the high post, and Kyle Corbett carries it. He did. He looked over to his coach real quickly, and Coach Duncan shakes his head and says, it's okay, you did. So back and forth turnovers.
I'm not sure Northfield's had success against that extended 1-3-1 the whole night. I think it's resulted in turnovers almost every time Coach Duncan's dialed it up.
Adams has it on the right side. Back to Maloney from 22 feet. Cannot get it to go. There's Gehring with it. Dakota Ezern tries to get the pass up the floor, but it's stolen away. Now down the floor, Veazey. Veazey can't get his shot to go. Kyle Corbett with it. He loses it on the floor. Blakely up the floor very quickly. Clausen has it. Layup. Good.
Dale Clausen kind of cherry picking there. But those 2 points awfully sweet for the Eagles after a little run by Northfield.
Up by 10 now, 27-17, 2:50 left in the first half to play. Why not another three, Maloney? He's going to hit one someday, but not right now. Blakely pulls down the big rebound. He's up very quickly, looks at the clock, has plenty of time, backs it out. Cody Ezern, Kyle Corbett, he's on the left side. He'll take a three-point shot from the left wing, nothing. Ball fought for, kick out of bounds off of Kyle. And hitting his head on the floor was McAdams. And he's rolling around, grimacing in pain, holding his head, and the official's going to hold everything and make sure he's okay. That's one thing we want to make sure is that the kids are all right. He shakes his head. He said, I'm okay. Wave it off, and he needs a timeout. He's going to come out of the lineup, shaking his head. Well, you could hear the big thud. I didn't know it was his head, but I'm glad he's okay. And he shakes it off, holding his head and squinting and looking up and squinting and holding it, but he's okay. Good to see that. David McAdams, the senior, lone senior for Wichita. Maloney, entry pass, turn around, no good. 3 seconds in the paint. That's Quentin Zimmerman.
Eagles up 10 here, just over 2 minutes to play in the half. Boy, Ian Gehring jumping up and down. He really wanted that ball.
Yeah, he did. He was doing jumping jacks. Inside Blakely. He's held, but he gets a shot to go. Blakely has 5, make it 6 in the quarter. 2 minutes left before half. 29-17. It's all Ellenwood. The crowd's getting behind it. They want a turnover. They get it. Stepping on the out-of-bounds line, Adam Yoder.
That last possession, Ian Gehring, not your traditional post-up, but he made himself a presence down low, drew the defense. Kyle Blakely was just wide open on the backside there for an easy bucket.
James Elder, a 5'4", 8th grader, was just on the floor. He played for about 30 seconds. He comes out very quickly. Lucas Macy is now on the floor. Inbound play. Blakely, he cannot get it. Or it was a toss inside, and then Clausen came over with a little touch foul. 2 free throws coming up for Damian Avizi.
A little bit of a force there. For the most part, Ellenwood's played well within themselves in this game. Cale Clausen, I believe, picked up his third.
First free throw for Avizi. He is good. He has 4 points. Hayes in for Clausen. Tanner Osborne, Brett Whalen, Chance Clausen, 3 seniors, still yet to even suit up. Still battling injuries for Ellenwood. Second free throw is missed. Offensive foul. Whistled on David McAdams, who was fined after banging his head on the turf.
There is a little bit of good news on the injury front.
It's really not the turf. Sorry about that.
We're talking about injuries. Chance Clausen could be released next week and back on the team.
Be a 1-on-1 coming up for South Coleman. No, they're going to call offensive foul on Ian Gehring sitting on the screen on the inside moving. If so, I think it's his third. Well, that's good to hear. We'll see if Clausen will get any playing time in the final 2 games before the Christmas break, though, next week, Tuesday at Otis Bison, I believe. But maybe they'll hold him off until after the break. We'll wait and see. That might be the best move. That is number 3 on Gehring, who came out of the lineup.
Champ has been able to go full speed in practice. He's not quite ready to turn him loose game-wise.
That is good news. You remember back when he broke his, what we thought was just a toe, back in the Hoisington football game, which was, game three of the football season. So he's come a long ways, and it's hard for anybody, especially a senior, to miss almost their entire football season and the start of the basketball season. The free throw is missed by McAdams. He will get a second, and it's on its way, and it's no good also. Long rebound, Aiken Blakely, but he gets it stolen away. Three-point shot, Maloney. It will not fall again. Offensive rebound on that weak side putback, Adam Yoder. He has four in a game. It's now just a nine-point advantage. 1:10 left before half, 29-20. Corbett dribbling between the circles. Finds Ringery inside Blakely. He takes a 12-footer from the baseline, nothing. Flat-footed offensive rebound for Garrett Hayes, but his putback will not fall. Vizi gets the rebound. He's up off the court very quickly, and he carries it. Another turnover of carrying the basketball. We've seen it at least three times tonight by this club.
That's 19 turnovers for the Suns, and boy, the vast majority of them just on that carry.
50 seconds left before half. Patrick Ringering inside. To Hayes, back to Ringering. Ringering up top to Corbett. Thought about a three. He dribbles in, lowers his head. Can't get his shot to fall. Offensive rebound. Hayes, good.
Good. Hayes has been something of a beast in there on the offensive board. He's probably got five, and if he could just finish off of those, he'd have a nice night going. But the offensive rebound has been a definite plus for Garrett Hayes this evening.
20 seconds before the Barton Community College halftime show on the Star 107.9. Three-point shot. McAdams, nothing. Offensive rebound, pulled down Jake Christensen, and a reach-in foul called on Adam Yoder. Shooting 1-1 for the Ellenwood Eagles, and Christensen, I believe it is. Jake did not shoot free throws in game one.
Well, Jake's a work in progress almost every level of the offensive game. Let's see how he does at the free throw line here.
Couldn't get it to fall. Rebound pulled down by Purple. 7 seconds. Clock rolls. Maloney has it. He's at the three-point line on the left side. He takes a shot with 2 seconds left. It hits the top of the backboard. Will not go anywhere. Turnover. Point four.
Maloney has struggled. I think he's forcing the action quite a bit right now.
Point 4 seconds. Coach Fair says don't foul. Corbett wants it. He's going to catch it and then shoot it. Point 4 seconds. Into Corbett. Oh,
That was way too quick.
No. They're going to hold everything because he didn't even touch the ball. He didn't even touch the ball, and the horn sounded. Point four back on the clock. Kyle Corbett did not even touch the basketball, and the horn sounded. We will get another opportunity. Put point four back on the clock. Kyle Corbett, if he wants, they can bounce the ball out because Northfield is playing back at half court. Kyle Corbett can run up to catch the ball, let it bounce out in front of him. He'll catch it and then just heave it up and try to get something to fall. The chances are slim, but it's going to be fun.
Kyle Corbett's
rubbing his hands. He wants to take a chance.
I was wondering why Kyle didn't move up to three-quarter court so they could get him the ball a little farther up. They did start it as soon as the ball bounced inbounds. Come close to any hands yet. Coach Dole going to come over and try and figure out how to put point four up on that clock.
Well, I'm surprised that Northfield is standing at the half court line. They should come out here towards the free throw line their own so Kyle Corbett can't just catch it, turn and shoot. There's plenty of time with 0.4 seconds left to catch and shoot.
I'm not sure they can put 0.4 up on the clock. It looks like a struggle, and I don't know what's going to happen here.
Well, I can count 0.4.
I've done it a few times on that clock, but I'm not sure you can get down to just 0.4.
1 point. Uh-oh.
Oh, boy, how do you like trying to hit 0.4 of a second?
I feel sorry for the young lady running the score clock. Kyle's warming up.
They're going to give it another try as the clock hits zero one more time.
Thanks for tuning in to KZRS, Star 107.9. Here we go, 31-20. Kyle Corbett's going to catch it and try to shoot. We'll see if we can get something.
He should move up into that space.
It's going to bounce. I think, is he going to let it bounce a few times?
Yeah, Kyle's telling him to lead him, and here comes an opportunity for a steal. Kyle's got it.
He won't make this at all. But Northfield waited for it to bounce, and they came up fresh. Halftime, 31-20. Barton Community College halftime show is here. It's 31-20. Ellenwood leads. We'll take a timeout and check back in with you shortly. Back after this on the
group, and that was just amazingly generous, and it's just wonderful.
It's not just limited to Barton employees for this particular drive that you guys do. You'll take any and all donations, correct?
Oh, correct. As I've stated many times to Barton employees, I'm completely and utterly shameless when it comes to begging for money for this cause, because it is such a worthy cause. If you do want to donate, you can, of course, send it on to the college, and I will definitely get it. If you do make a check out, I would ask that you make it out to the Fort Riley Fisher House Fund. And you can send it directly to me. My name is Janet Balk, and you can send it to P.O. Box 2463, Building 217, Fort Riley, Kansas, 66442.
I know that the Fisher House Foundation has a 4-star rating. How much of our money that you bring in goes to our Fisher House Fund Drive?
100%. Of anybody's donations to the Fort Riley Fisher House goes directly to the Fisher House Foundation.
Have you ever tried to guess how many individuals you've actually helped with the Fort Riley Fisher House Fund?
We've tried to figure that out. Let's say that every person gets a $50 gift card. If you take a look at what we've been able to gather so far, not taking into account this year, but taking into account over the past several years, that's getting close to 150 people that have gotten gift cards just from what we have done. You know, it doesn't sound like much, but if you can even afford $5, that will get somebody something that, like a magazine. It will give somebody a sense of home, a sense of comfort, a sense of there are people that we hear that we care about you. It's Christmas. We know that you are away from your family. You're having to spend it in a hospital. That's terrible enough. You're spending, you know, you've been injured. Thank you for your service. Thank you for what you've done. And, you know, here's something that we can do for you.
Thanks, Janet, for joining us. This is Michael Dawes saying so long.
The Ellenwood Booster Club would like to wish all the Eagle athletic teams good luck this season. Support the Eagles and join the Ellenwood Booster Club by contacting a booster committee member. The Ellenwood Booster Club, a proud supporter of Eagle sports. Ellenwood Packing Plant is proud to be a sponsor of Ellenwood Eagles Sports. Serving Central Kansas for over 30 years, Ellenwood Packing Plant is your main source for beef and pork cuts. Plus, don't forget about the fresh deli. Ellenwood Packing Plant wishes all the Ellenwood Eagle athletes good luck and congratulates them on achieving the teamwork, leadership, and good sportsmanship. Ellenwood Packing Plant on 56 Highway, just west of Ellenwood.
Welcome you back with Wes Phelan on the Star 107.9 Barton Community College Halftime Show. Get driven at Barton Community College. Their guys and gals basketball team playing pretty well this year. They are done for the Christmas holiday break, and then they'll be back in action starting in January. A lot of conference games will take place, so good luck to the Cougars. And good luck to the Illinois Eagles as they come out for the second half. They get set for second half action. We give you the halftime stat. Kyle Corbett had 9 points. 6 points for Kyle Blakesley. 6 points for Garrett Hayes. 5 points for Patrick Ringer. 2 points apiece. Cale Clausen, Jake Christensen, and Ian Gehring. Ellenwood shot 2 of 7 from the the three-point line. While the free throw line, they put up 7 and converted 4 of them. They had 11 turnovers, 15 rebounds, 7 on the offensive end, 5 steals in that first half. They did have 9 assists. 11 and 16 free throws to keep Wichita Northfield in the game in the first half. They turned the ball over 21 times, only had 9 rebounds. We are set for second half action, and Wes, you have to like the play of the Ellenwood Eagles here in this first half.
Yeah, they've definitely brought a little more energy. I think they've been a lot more focused and efficient with the basketball. And this second half is going to be kind of a test of wills to stay with basketball the Coach Shane Duncan way and not play it the way we saw it Friday night.
31-20, we start second half action of the Illinois preseason basketball tournament. Day number one, Kyle Blakeslee throws up his shot, won't fall, traveled with it. It looked like he took a couple of steps, dribbling down that paint, and he got whistled for it. They nailed him.
There's definitely been eagle eye on that stuff.
Personal fouls for Garrett Allen in that first half is three. He's 6'5", and he starts on the bench for Wichita Northfield.
And he was absolutely a force in the middle, especially defensively. Not sure what our crack stat man Derek Moose had, but I thought he had four blocks. Derek's got him with three. That sounds good. An impressive half.
Now working the ball around is Northfield. Timeout. Let's take it. 32-20. Some other stats in that first half. What?
Timeout on the court. We would like to take this opportunity to thank tonight's sponsors, Next Tech Wireless and Star 107.9. Timeout on the court. We would like to take this opportunity to thank tonight's sponsors, Next Tech Wireless and Star 107.9.
Inside from Ellenwood, doing a better job of boxing out and controlling the inside glass, limiting second chance opportunities.
32-20, we're just underway here in this second half. Out of the timeout, Northfield trying to break that trap pressure defense right up in your face, in your grill by the Ellenwood Eagles, and they fall back into their 1-3-1 look. Clausen, Gearing. Now a trap on that far side right in the corner. There's Corbin and Blakeslee, and they force a turnover.
Well, they're doing a good job of picking and choosing when they trap. They came out, trapped first pass, then they trapped corner over there. Coach Duncan's got a couple different areas that he really likes to attack with that trap and gotten turnovers out of Northfield with it.
Well, Clausen says, I'm wide open. I'll take the shot, but he misses it from 13 on the rebound. It's a jump ball. Stays with the Eagles. Gehring tied up.
Boy, Kale works so hard. Coach Duncan's doing everything he can to get the young man 2 points on the board this evening. Kale's going to keep working hard whether they're falling or not. Ian Gehring off the inbounds. Nice job flashing to the open area. 2 points for the junior, Ian Gehring.
Gehring getting some points. Everybody that has played, well, not everybody has scored, but most people have contributed in some shape.
Oh, everybody that's been in the game has something positive on the stat sheet for him tonight. Great inside look there to Ian Gehring. Kicks it back out, reverses to Corbett. Corbett takes the drive. Can't get the shot. Ian Gehring, offensive rebound. Putback won't go. Out of bounds to the Suns.
What great work effort right there by the Ellenwood Eagles was. They were really fighting for that basketball, just couldn't get that second chance bucket to go down.
There it is, the 1-3-1 with Patrick extended all the way to half court.
Northfield just moving the basketball around, but Ellenwood is really flying on their defensive end. There's a shot, but it's a foul. It is on Gehring. It'll be his fourth, I believe, and it's a good call. I mean, he did hammer.
Ian was finally breaking through. Two good trips for him. Then he picks up that fourth foul. That's kind of been the way the basketball season has gone for Ian Gehring. At the free throw line for Northfield.
Yeah, at first I thought that was Yoder, but it's not. It's Zimmerman. He shoots two. Missed the first one. Hayes is in. Gehring's out.
Been really impressed with Garrett Hayes this evening. I'm sure I've said it before. Not a guy that played varsity last year. He was actually a C-teamer.
It's not a good foul right there by Demian Avizi over the back.
No, that's really a lazy foul there. It's, you don't get them back once you commit them.
No.
Kyle Corbett bringing the ball up. Patrick Ringering at the timeline. ring a ring, passes out of the trap to Corbett. Corbett, they're going to call a travel. Kyle looks like, I'm not sure about that, but going to throw the ball back to the referee. It's going to be Northfield basketball.
14-point advantage for Ellenwood. Been a fun game. Corbett up top, guarding with that 1-3-1. There's a lay, and it's good by Yoder. Yoder just went around three Ellenwood Eagles on that baseline, able to get a reverse. Well, not a reverse, but a layup on the left side. But how about the play on the inside?
Still crossing over to Big Daddy Garrett Hayes for the Deuce. Garrett Hayes coming up with
10 already in this game. That's great effort.
Turnover, Northfield. Now they'll get it back after a near steal.
Three-point shot by Yoder. It's partially blocked by Blakesley, who streaks down the right side of the floor, up very quickly, ring-a-ring to Blakesley. Blakesley gets the shot to fall, and he's fouled. Blakesley going to the free throw line to shoot one.
Kyle's been quiet tonight with just 8 points going into that one. That's a great move, taking the ball hard in. Wichita Northfield's been physical in there. Ellenwood's not shied away, driving to the basket.
38-22, make it 39-22. The free throw is good. Blakesley, 2 of 3. He's hit his last two from the stripe.
This is basically going to be Ellenwood's version of the press this year. We're not going to see a whole lot of press. It's going to be this half-court 1-3-1.
I like it because it really can cause a lot of confusion for the other team. Beasley drives in, shot rattled out. It was a nice shot, but he couldn't get it to fall. But how about Patrick Ringering fighting for that basketball coming from the, well, from about the free throw line and ran after it, that loose ball, and tried to save it inbounds. He stepped on that baseline, though. There's
good
a trap,
trap
on the inbound.
Good trap on that first pass.
Beasley, he's double-teamed. Blakely falls to the ground. Three-point shot way up in the air, and it goes out of bounds. That was one of those high-arcing three-point shots that Zimmerman really didn't have much range on.
Kyle almost dribbled into a trap himself, gets the ball back in the middle field. Patrick Ringering underneath to Cale Clawson. There'll be a foul.
Nice sportsmanship by Clawson as he knocked, I believe it was
VZ, wasn't it?
VZ got knocked to the ground, and Clawson immediately helped him up, and then Clawson goes to the free throw line where he gets a chance to make two more points.
Two on VZ. Cale Clawson at the line here.
Has not shot a free throw tonight, and I don't know if he wants to shoot that one again because he barely struck iron. KU Jayhawks got a big win tonight. Did I mention that earlier, Wes?
Oh, I knew it'd come out sooner or later.
That's all right, UK Stater.
They are very, very good. That has to be said.
So it's Gate State. They're not bad. Second free throw also missed. Northfield gets the rebound. Ooh, Corbett almost came up.
Boy, Kyle was almost there with the steal.
Maloney misses it. Rebound. Clawson finds Kyle Corbett. He looks up the floor, and he'll pull it back in and set the range. Ringering. Left side. Up top, Corbett. Corbett sets up the offense. Calls Big Daddy over. On the left side. Down in the left block. Corbett wide open three. Top of the key. Good. Kyle Corbett had nothing but the bottom of the net for his first three of the night. His 12th point of the game.
Surprisingly, that's the last piece of Kyle's game to come around this year. The outside shot's always been his favorite part of the game. Once he gets that going, he is quite a basketball player.
Blakely gets the rebound, and he loses the handle. Looks like he was fouled. No. Yes, it is a foul. Okay, foul is called on Adrian Maloney.
His first?
That's what I have, his first personal foul. Team foul number 4 on the Suns. And they're purple and white, trimmed in some yellow. Ringering dribbles left side, throws it up off the glass, cannot get it to fall. Blakely fighting for the offensive board, gets it, jump ball, goes over to Northfield. Here comes Cody Ezern to the scorer's table. 42-22, leads up to 20. It was 32-20 at half.
Oh, Kyle Blakely, good job sliding through a box out there, picking up an offensive rebound, and then drawing a foul.
Blakely up top for three from 19. It's too short. Rebound. Cody Eason cannot save it.
Cody Eason lays out, gives the 100% effort there to come up with a ball. Since they're playing Wichita Northfield, got to talk about Brett Whalen. He's got the knee injury, but there's a possibility he might be back sooner than the 6 weeks that was expected. He's going to see a doctor and have things checked out. Maybe he'll be back a little sooner than expected. He scored 19 against this Northfield team the first time around a couple years back.
Blakely on the other end after the block. He can't get a 12-footer from the baseline to go. Rebound. Northfield, they're up the floor very quickly, but how about Ellenwood's defense? Smothering defense all over the place. Big Daddy Garrett Hayes gets the rebound, but he loses it. There's Corbett to get it up the floor. Kyle Corbett almost into a double team. Dribbles inside. Nice dish from Kyle Corbett to Big Daddy Garrett Hayes for his 12th point of the game. Now on the other end, offensive charge, setting his feet on the left side of the floor with Kale Clausen. Nice shot by Clausen.
Kale's had a rough time putting the ball in the hole, but Coach Duncan will love that charge you just drew. Kale will never slow down, whether the ball goes in or out. He's always going to give you everything he's got in the tank. And that's one reason why he's out there four quarters a night, because you don't ever have to worry about Kale Clausen fighting through everything out there and giving you the best of what he has.
Blakely, Ezer between the circles. Over to Blakely, who is now on the right side. Blakely for three, can't get it. Offensive rebound. Who? Guess who? Guess who?
Hayes again, number 13 and 14.
There it is. He knocks it in. Garrett Hayes right now is the player of the game. He is playing awesome basketball tonight. Almost a turnover. Cody Eason almost came up with it. Northfield trying to find some type of spark, some type of momentum, just trying to get a little confidence back into their game. 46-22. 1:56 left in the third. It is all Ellenwood in this third quarter. Inbounds play. Yoder. Yoder will dribble the ball back up top and set the lineup. Yoder to Maloney. Back to Yoder. He'll take a three. No good. It's too short. Rebound. Pop four, who comes down with it. Ringer, he does. He's trapped. He gets it off to Cody Eason. Cody Eason has a three on two break. Nice ball fake by Cody Eason. Goes in for the layup. It's too short, but he's fouled. He goes to the line to shoot two.
Ellenwood's done an excellent job recognizing the opportunities that they have. And Cody saw he had a chance to get in the lane there and drew a foul.
46-22. Seventh team foul on Northfield. We have yet to see Garrett Allen in this third quarter. He has three personal fouls. Big hand for Garrett Hayes and Kyle Blakely.
Boy, Garrett sure earned that hand tonight, and Kyle Blakely's been a little bit behind the scenes, but effective as well.
Christensen, Clausen, the free throw is missed. Eason, Corbett, and Ringering on the floor right now. 1:20 left in the third, 46-22. It's all Ellenwood. Another turnover off of Northfield. They can't hang on to the basketball.
Got 25 turnovers for them right now, Steve, and that's been a big part of the game, if not the ultimate difference.
I'm not for sure if Coach Fair realizes that his big man only has three fouls. Corbett for three, top of the key, why not? He's feeling it now. He has back-to-back trays in the quarter.
I really like the way Kyle's kind of ran the team tonight. I know he's hit the back-to-back threes, but I think he's done a very effective job at the point guard tonight.
49-22, under a minute to go. We're in the third period of the fourth and final game of the round-robin tournament. First round, Ellenwood preseason tournament. Pass inside Yoder, left-handed shot, rattles in. It went around in circle, dipsy-doo, dozy-do, and all the way down to the bottom of the hole. 49-24.
Just the fourth point of the third quarter by Wichita Northfield. Does that seem right, Steve?
Not at all. Both of them by Yoder. Now a turnover. No. Yep. It is a turnover on Ellenwood. Christensen, though, will be whistled for the personal foul. Team foul number two. Christensen second, I believe. Maybe third.
I've got two.
Yep. Foul being Congratulations.
23 seconds. They've yet to start the clock. And now they'll start the clock, and we'll do it again.
Coach Duncan, Bill Duncan, and Shane Duncan both trying to get their first wins tonight. Shane Duncan is on his way to doing it, and Bill Duncan has already done it.
They'll accept 18.7 is what we have left in the third quarter. Winning girls coach Bill Duncan sitting right up here next to us. Eating a little bit of candy. Well-deserved sweets tonight, Coach.
10 seconds to play. Ellenwood trying to get a stop. We're in the third quarter. The Eagles lead 49-24. Now there's five. Now there's four. Yoder has it. He throws up a shot at the buzzer that will not fall, and the rebound comes down to Ellenwood. 49-24. End of three. Back after this on the Star 107.9.
Let the Marmies make it happen for you. Three generations, two dealerships, one big selection. Whether you're looking for a car, a truck, a crossover, minivan, or SUV, we've got them. The choosing is easy. Come by and see us.
Find what drives you at Barton. And if you are unsure what you want to do, Barton can help you with that as well. Campus tours are available, so call the admissions office today and get driven with Barton.
That's the fourth and final quarter, 49-24. Steve Owens, Wes Balin on the Star, 107.9, and Ian Gehring jumps high up into the rafters and tips it away.
Good start to the fourth quarter there. Ian Gehring tips the ball out of bounds. Ellenwood holds the Suns to just 4 points in the third quarter. Excellent defense by the Eagles.
Not many second chance opportunities in that third quarter like we saw in the first half for Northfield. Ellenwood is not. Ooh, Nellis. Bad foul on Ian Gehring. Is that five? Possibly.
Ian Gehring is finished with the reach in foul there.
Yeah, he tried to set his feet and he gets called for that hip check. The scoring column does not tell the pitcher that what Ian Gehring did tonight on the defensive end. He finishes the game with two, but he played really well. 3-point shot. Yoder, no good. There's the rebound by the 6'5" Garrett. Good. Turnaround shot. Garrett Allen, just his first field goal, though, of the game.
Garrett Allen, if he doesn't miss a lot of the second quarter, you wonder what kind of numbers he could have put up with that athleticism. Kyle Corbett all the way to the hole. Nice penetration. That's the best thing you could see out of Kyle Corbett. Putting the ball on the floor, getting to the rim. That's a well-rounded basketball play.
Corbett leads the team with 17. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 jerseys on the floor with gentlemen rolling around on the ground fighting for the basketball. And it goes over to Ellenwood due to the jump ball scenario. Corbett has it. 7 minutes left. We're a minute into the fourth and final. 51-26. First game, first day of the Ellenwood preseason tournament. Trapped on Patrick Ringery, but he gets out of it to Clausen. Kyle Corbett dribbles left side, good.
Again, Kyle Corbett has an opportunity at a jump shot, turns it down, finds a better shot on the baseline, lays it up and in, gets to the line for the traditional three-point play.
A nice job by Kyle Corbett. He's done a better job dribbling inside the paint, dribbling baseline, and getting those inside shots. He has knocked down a couple of trays back in the third quarter also.
Absolutely. Just a fine, well-rounded game from Kyle.
Kyle just misses the free throw, and he smiles because nobody like went to get the rebound, so he grabs it and lays it in for two. Rebound pulled down by Blakeslee after the missed shot. Patrick Gregory looked in and layup misses, but there's Blakeslee. He misses the offensive rebound. Another offensive rebound, Claussen, and he can't handle it. Maloney comes out with it. Maloney setting up the offense. Ball's tipped out of bounds off of Corbett. No, as they say, it goes off of Purple. 55-26. Northfield trailing by 29.
26 turnovers for the Northfield Suns. That's been a big part of the demise as well.
Corbett has it. He is ringering. Big Daddy Garrett Hayes out there along with Claussen and Blakeslee. 6 minutes to play. There's Corbett inside Claussen. Right-handed shot. Will not go. It was a wild shot. Garrett Allen comes out with it. The 6'5" post player. And he throws it back to Maloney, who lobs it back to Garrett, but it's tipped out of bounds. Garrett Allen maybe looking for a little slam-a-jamma right there.
What I think he was looking for. I thought it was a straight turnover, but they're going to say it was out off of Ellenwood.
Kale Claussen, I know I've called him Kyle tonight at least once with the Kyle Corbett and Kyle Blakeslee. But Kale Claussen just comes off the floor for Derek Ward. Whistle on the inbounds. Is that Garrett? Yes, Garrett Hayes. Team foul number 5, number 3 on Garrett. Kyle Corbett tips it around.
How about that? How many times have we seen Patrick Ringling go crashing out of bounds to get a loose ball?
He's been into the wall a couple of separate times, into the stands at least twice. Inbounds play to Allen, the 6'5 post. Turn around, right-handed shot, no good. Over the back on Adam Yoder.
But that was a really nice post move. Showed the ball one way, then drop step into the lane. Missed the shot. Foul on Yoder. His fifth, team's ninth. So Yoder, the kid who scored their scored 2 points for him in the third quarter, is done for the evening with 5:47 left. Eagles comfortably in front, 55-26.
Real nice hustle by that young man.
Boy, I know it's been a lopsided victory tonight, but you know, these kids from Northfield have come out giving a good effort. They're going to get back to Wichita awful late tonight, Steve.
Yeah, they sure are. Getting late. Already 9:45 past my bedtime, but that's all right. Won't be like Coach Duncan to go walk my dog tonight. 5:40 to play in this contest, 55-26. Still a little bit more whistles, more fouls. Coach Bear still coaching his team. Not going to go down without giving a complete effort.
Two on Patrick, little lob inside to Allen. Allen with a nice post move, won't go down. Ball out off of Derek Ward. 5:37 to go in the fourth.
Another lob on the inbound. Garrett knocks it loose. Patrick Ringring runs it down. He's on the right side. He uses the right hand. Remember, he's a left-hander. He's able to lay it in with the right hand. He gets it to fall. He's fouled. He'll go to the line and shoot one.
Well, that kind of came out of an assist there off sort of a wild play on the out-of-bounds.
Clock is running. So all four games today, Wes, ended up with a running clock in the fourth quarter. That's something you don't see every day.
Maybe not the most aesthetic basketball in the world, but number 3, McAdams, kind of had a loose ball, and he just punched it ahead, and Patrick just ran onto it and picked up the layup.
That's team foul number 10, but just a bonus opportunity for Ringring. Phenomenal knee bend. Great elevation from the free throw line.
Junior Micah Yellow Wolf going to check in for the Eagles here, get a little time in.
So we got Corbett, the Yellow Wolf, Blakeslee, also Derek Ward, and Garrett Hayes.
Alan Osco's checked in for the Northfield Suns as well to finish this one off.
Just two starters on the floor for Ellenwood. Layup misses. Allen tips it out of bounds, and they'll say it went off of Blakesley.
That's an interesting call. I thought it was off of Allen.
Thought maybe we'd see a dunk by Allen in this game. Still a lot of time, though. 4:10 to play. Clock rolls. 58-26. Ellenwood. Inbound stolen by Yellowwood.
Cal Corbett bringing it up over the timeline. Just taking it easy. Got the low dribble working. Sets up the set. Here goes Kyle in the lane. Stolen.
That was Maloney with the steal. He'll throw up a two-point shot very quickly. Will not fall. Rebound pulled down by Allen Ozoski. Two-point shot by him. Will not fall. Ball is loose on the floor. Who's going to come up with it? Northfield does it. And he travels.
They call a travel on Allen there.
He's earned back on the floor for probably Kyle Corbett.
Well, Kyle's had a nice game. It'd be nice if he comes off the floor. He gets a big hand from the home fans.
And Blakesley off the floor for Christensen. So all the starters are now off and a great hand by what fans are remaining here in Ellenwood Gymnasium.
That's all awful long to Yellowwood, but he runs it down and dribbles it off his foot out of bounds. Micah came over to Ellenwood from Great Bend. He played some soccer, hadn't played basketball for a while, so he's definitely a raw talent, but he's got some good athleticism.
Running layup will not go. Hold on the rebound on Christensen. But the clock will not stop due to the 30-point margin. 58-26, Ellenwood is winning this game.
Garrett Hayes trying to work his way into fouling out of this ball game.
You can see that the 6'5 post player who just missed another right-handed shot does not have the left hand. I mean, he has the left hand, but he can't shoot the ball with that left hand because he's had plenty of opportunities to put the ball up west with that left hand, and he just hasn't developed it yet.
Good look off there by Maloney down to Quentin Zimmerman. Foul on the Eagles. Opportunity for Zimmerman at the line here. Foul's going to go on Derek Ward. Zimmerman hits the first free throw.
Coming into the lineup for his first action, or back into the lineup, is Cale Clausen. Great hand for Garrett Big Daddy Hayes. He's the man of the hour.
Both free throws good for Zimmerman. Brings the lead back to 30. Turnover by Cody Ether. Maloney up with a layup and in. Maloney just his sixth point on the evening. Derek Ward trapped in the corner looking for some help. Ball's going to be out off of Ward. Northfield ball, 1:10 to play. Ellenwood leads 58-30. Inbounding the ball will be Quentin Zimmerman and Maloney. Maloney takes a long three, not this time. Rebound, Cale Clausen. Clausen dribbles up out of trouble. Cody Ether behind the back, over half court. Derek Ward couldn't get it. Mike Ellenwood with the follow finish. Count it. Ellenwood by 30, 40 seconds left.
How about that play right there, by was that Cody Ether out there?
Cody Ether with the behind the back. Maloney misses the three. Going to be another rebound for Micah Yellowwolf. Brings it up. Yellowwolf. Derek Ward can't get it out of bounds. Northfield ball. Clock might wind out here. 18 seconds and running. Zimmerman into Maloney. Maloney over the timeline. Maloney going to take an NBA-style three. You betcha.
Why not?
He's had a quiet night, but he'll end it with a bang there. Yellow Wolf dribbles the ball up into the front court. Up ahead, Derek Ward! You bet that 3 points. Ellenwood wins 62-33. Big win for the Eagles after a rough night against Russell. I don't know that they got everything in order, but they definitely got some ghost exercise tonight, Steve.
Great wins tonight for the Ellenwood Lady Eagles, and the Ellenwood Eagles will take a timeout on our post-game show. It's the Abby Carpet post-game show.